Alright, so this video is basically for anybody who wants to make a cooler stereo and just doesn't know how, doesn't have any idea, you know, it's disassembled. I'm not going to go into great detail because this is pretty self-explanatory, but, you know, when you have an amp, and this is a cheap $40 amp, don't, you know, unless you have the money and you want to, don't buy expensive stuff when you're doing this. The only expensive thing you need to buy is this right here. Good sounding, quality speakers. Or you can do the cheapies at Walmart. It's your build. Do it, you know, this is just to give you an idea. And you really don't know how to do it, super simple. You got ground, power, remote. And this is for a switch setup. You don't have to have a remote if you don't want the switch. And then very basic speaker. These go to your speakers. Positive, negative, so like I said, super self-explanatory. You don't have to raid your car or go down to AutoZone and buy the very last small battery and, you know, leave some guy out of luck because you've got a car battery in a cooler. Look at this one right here. I bought this at Academy Sporting Goods store. It's got a picture of a deer on it. I think it's a deer feeder battery. You can get these at Academy Sporting Goods store. If you find an Interstate battery dealership, they'll have different sizes. This one happens to be 12 volts, sealed lead acid. You can have it down like this. I wouldn't, but you know, it's whatever. 7.5 amperage, 20 hours. They make them in 9, 10. Make sure it's a 12 volt and leave your big fat 70 pound car battery in your car, you know, that way you can go to the store and work in places. 20 bucks. These last forever if you run them all the way down and then charge them up. Triple charger, super simple, runs out. This I also bought at Academy. I want to say it was like 50 bucks, but you know, little light says it's good, not for long. It should go to orange. That's all you need. You can find smaller batteries, sealed lead acid. They work great. You don't, you know, light. Don't get the big fat car battery. $20 compared to 40, 50, 60 on a big, heavy, super, something you don't need. Cheap amp, good speakers. And then you need one of these RCA to, 3.5 millimeter jack? Yeah, okay. And then, you know, if you want an iPhone, if you got your iPhone, MP3 player, iPod, CD player, whatever you got to power it. A cooler of your design, it's basically, I've got two models I'm gonna show you, but this is the one where I've got the speakers on the outside. I've got one where I've got the speakers on the inside. And like I said, if you want a switch, you know, that'll come with the remote and all that. Basically, when you get done, you're not going to have a crane or a forklift or five guys to pick up a stereo with a car battery and a cassette, a CD deck and all that. You don't need all that madness. This is what you need right here. All for around, well, right around 200 bucks. After you get done with the connections and other little miscellaneous stuff you need, screws, you'll be good to go. So as you can see, I've already cut the holes for the speakers. I'm not gonna pop that out because it's a pain in the butt, but that's snug in there tight. It's just a little switch I got from Radio Shack. It's a lighted LED. See, cut a hole, popped it in, no problem. In here, you see those two little L brackets I've got? That's to hold your battery down. And this is what I mean. It'll just hold it in place. A little tidbit of information, when you're drilling into the plastic here, all you have to do is apply some pressure with the screwdriver. You know, if you've got a power drill, don't go nuts with it. You know, tighten it down snug and then leave it alone. If you go crazy with it, you're pretty much just gonna drill a hole and it's gonna be useless. So, okay, so like I said, you know, I don't want to go too much into detail, but if you've never done this before, it's pretty simple.
you've got these connections, these go to your speakers, and of course, you know, you've got your red for your power, your negative is your black, and you get those wired up. You don't want them too long, but you want them long enough that, you know, you could sit there and take it out and play with it. You know, if you ever got to do any tweaking, if you're going to do a switch, you want to do your remote. And this is what I want to show you. If you're doing your switch, you take two pieces of wire. This is two pieces of wire right here. And you do one to your power. And you take one connector and you butt it up against. You see how that's done? Right there? Okay, you butt it up and then you put a connector on this. This is going to go from your battery. Then this is going to go to your switch. Same thing with your ground. I'm not exactly sure if that's a real proper way to do it, but it works, and this is what I've done. So same thing with this one, just butt them up, connect it, then your remote, just one straight wire, same length, one connector. Then on your rear, this is how you control your iPod, your CD player, whatever you're going to do. Ta-da! Super simple, not too hard to figure out. You know, there you go. And of course, input level. This is a super cheap amp, super simple. Whenever you plug your iPod MP3 player, you can sit here and, you know, figure this out for your volume and make it sound right. We're just gonna kind of mount everything. You've got everything wired. You know, this is super, super basic. I've got screws around here somewhere. Now, whatever cooler you decide to go with, whether you're going to do them on the sides, on the top, you know, through here, it's a good idea to find a cooler that's got a relatively flat face. You get the one with the ridges, you know, you're gonna have little air, you know, seeping through. It's gonna sound like crap. That's pretty flat, you know. It's got a little bit of a gap right here, but there's a little gasket that I put on it that came with the speakers, actually, and works great. And depending on what speakers you use, it's a good idea to go ahead and plug them in first, you know, just depending, because once you get them in there, all that foam and all that other stuff's going to be in the way. So plug them in, of course, you know, negative, negative, positive. That's, you know, Fisher Price, my first stereo wiring deal. Then ta-da. Now that you've got your speakers mounted, like I said, you're going to end up with this jazz right here. Let's get everything nice and... You're going to have a spaghetti wire mess in here. And see? Nice and simple. Now this is what I was talking about with your remote switch. See, let's get the power. Power. See how I've got two? One's going to go to your battery. This is the part that confused me because I'm an idiot. See, when I mounted this switch, right there on the side of the switch, you've got power, you've got load or remote, and then you've got ground.
when I put it in there, I labeled it so I'd remember which is which. So here we go. Power. And then do the same with your ground. I don't want to get in here. Okay. And you got your ground. If I'm doing this wrong, anybody out there that builds stereo coolers, please forgive me. I don't really care about your opinion. Just trying to help some people out, because no one seems to want to show somebody how to make a stereo cooler. And that's basically it right there. You've got your RCA ready to go. You've got your ground, your power, your remote. Super simple. Very, very, very easy. I neglected to make a little hole to bring my RCA through, so I just closed the lid on it. I'll doctor this up later. And you've got power. And let's get some tunes going, let you hear what this puppy sounds like. Like I said, super light, very easy to build. And basically all you have to have is the speakers, the amp, the battery. After you've got all that wired up, all that there it is. There's just the idea. You don't have to get a big old car battery. You don't have to go super elaborate. I mean, this is the most expensive deal on this is the speakers. I bought those at Best Buy for like $99. Everything else is just dirt cheap. I mean, it's a cooler stereo. You don't have to buy the Rockford Fosgate, the JLs. You don't have to go nuts with it. You know, have several different models. I'll put this other one together for you. But basically, super easy, and it sounds damn good. You can't, you know, can't deny that. What So I've also got another little setup here. I'm not gonna take all this stuff out. You know how it works. I went a little crazy with the wiring. This is the very first one I've ever made. Went a little crazy with the, overdid it with the wiring. I don't know exactly what happened there, but good times were had. This little amplifier, let me get a good shot of it. See how small it is? Super small. 25 watts per channel, two channel, and that was $30 at autotoys.com. And in the website, it has its own little search engine. If you type in super small amp, you'll find this little bad boy, and this will let you make super, super small. Not only light, but super small, you know, even smaller than this, you know, 4x6, you know, 5-inch speakers, you know, sky's the limit. And that is called the Road Rage, but like I said, autotoys.com, super small amp, $30 all day long. It's been a while since I bought one, but I think they should still be the same. It might have gone up, who knows, the economy. This is what I did different with this, with the power. The remote on this one, this particular amplifier, if you do decide to get it, like I said, autotoys.com, comes with its inline fuse holder. I forgot to show you that on the other one. Don't worry about it. Don't need it. The remote has to be spliced in with your power for this particular amp to work. They'll let you know about it when you buy the amp. I went ahead and did something different with this. I'll show you why.
this I bought from Radio Shack. It was a little combo pack with all this, well, that, and various uses, you know. I found the power in the negative on this, matched it up with, same deal here. This, you know, I've got a little red on here. This is my power, this is my negative. I'll show you why here in a minute. Put the battery back in here. Okay, with this particular design of cooler, you see absolutely nothing going on here. What I did was I mounted some L brackets to hold this plate in. This is medium density fiberboard. Great for speaker boxes. This, of course, is not a speaker box, but still good stuff. Put a little handle I found. Stole off a bum or something. I can't remember where I got it. That holds that in place. And you got your speakers mounted. You can sit there, jam out all day long. Call it night. You've got 25 pounds of little room. Absolutely nothing. And yeah, so let me put it together, show you this one. See, just like that other, this one has positive, negative. Super simple. Like I said, if you've never done this before, you know, it's very easy to figure out. You know, Google it, you know, ta-da. Like I said, I've got my wood, got my handle. Got a handle on my wood. Let's do this right here. You've got your RCA. You've seen that before. Now, with the power, I decided to do a little something different. This is what I decided to do. Watch this, folks. This, I think it's to do with the amp. I don't think you can do this with the larger amp. This pulls so much, you know, so small amount of power. It's just, it's a bare bones, you know, tiny little sucker of an amp. But let me show you. Got my power. Boop. All right. Now, like I said, I did a notch thing here. What did I do? Let's do it upside down. Who cares? Okay. Now, let's do this right here. Same thing. Great sound. Small little amp. It doesn't sound as good as that other, actually, but still damn good. Now, what I really wanted to show you with this design, this little chingadera here, turn off. Okay, let's get rid of that. Oh, you can just leave it on there. It's not sucking any power out. This is why I had this so long. Now I remember. It's all coming back to you. Watch this madness. Let's say you're just chilling. Say you're way too poor to have a home stereo, or you just want to do something cool. This, right here, my friends, this is why you would build a longer version of this right here. You know, as long as you want it. Because at Radio Shack, they have these little inverters plug into the wall. See? Now, let's see if I can get it to work. Like I said, with this amplifier, it works. I've tried it on larger, and it just uses too much power. Won't do it. See? Turns on. Heard a little pop in the speakers. I did. I don't know if you did. But see? Now, that's very low volume. I want to say if you turn it up way too loud, it'll start cutting out, because if the power's, the amp's sucking too much power and that little inverter just can't handle it. But watch this. Battery runs out, you don't have another one charged up because you can spend another $20 to have an extra standby. Plug it in, tuck it away, and you're mobile again. You can do it! Once you have all the guts, your speakers, your amp, your battery, pretty much the design of the cooler is up to you. Whether you want to do something concealed like that, something, you know, all out and flashy, or not so flashy, whatever you want to call it, it's basically up to you. The amp, the battery, your speakers, your music source, the cooler's up to you. Like I said, this one, just to give you an example, wouldn't be good for the speakers to be on the outside, because unless you're going to put them on the outside and then fill it up with silicone caulk, you know, you'll figure it out. It's all up to your imagination, or limited by your imagination. So super easy, go out and do it. Leave your car batteries in your car, leave your CD player in the car, just get the speakers out. That's all you need.